Hello and welcome to another video blog here at Supernaturally Healthy. I am Kezia Hall and today I'm here to talk to you about supplements. I often get asked what are my views on supplements and if I think they're worthwhile or if they're not natural and all pills should be avoided. And so I'm just going to clear that up a bit briefly today. So supplements are things that you take to supplement your diet. So often the most common thing would be a multivitamin. So what it is, it's synthetically formed vitamins and minerals put into a tiny, tiny pill form that someone would take every day to ensure that they meet their recommended daily allowance of those different vitamins and minerals. You can get a range of different supplements out there. Just go to any supermarket or health food shop, store and you see jars and jars of different pills. And often the big question is it natural? Is it natural, Kezia, to be taking supplements if you're actually eating a completely natural and real food diet? Because often all the pills and supplements that you see will be synthetically formed vitamins and minerals. There are a few supplements out there that are completely natural, things like fermented cod liver oil and maybe other oils like hemp oil and that kind of thing. And often some probiotics can be completely naturally sourced as well from using things like cultured dairy and just dehydrating it into a pill form. But overall, most supplements are synthetic. So are they natural and are they healthy? Now, this is all kind of, everyone has different views on this. So this is my personal opinion. And I do take supplements. I don't take tons every day and I am very considered about the ones that I do take, but I do take them. Why? I think a lot of this from my own research and reading that I've done, as I decided to take vitamins and supplements for a few reasons, some of which is over the last kind of 100, 150 years, the way that the food industry works it's just completely transformed. We used to buy locally from local farms and food was not so aggressively produced as it is now. Now we have a massive global food economy that goes on. We have machines doing loads and loads of work. And actually what it means is the farm land and the soil is being very aggressively farmed. And vitamins and minerals are really fragile things. They're not sturdy and they don't have, you know, what it takes to actually withstand a lot of the abuse that we've given it over the last kind of hundreds of years. And so actually it means our soil, there's lots of studies that show the mineral and vitamin content of our soil is, sorry, not vitamin content of the soil, but the mineral content of our soil is greatly reduced than what it was years and years ago, which means the growing of all our fruits and vegetables within it actually is less nutrient dense. So that's one of the reasons that I would take supplements, is that actually through our aggressive farming and through our kind of more industrialized food industry, we actually are getting food that isn't as nutritionally dense as what it was years and years ago. Another reason for doing it would be all the pesticides and herbicides that are all used now to, again, because of our aggressive farming model, actually, again, just really strips and either strips food of its vitamin, of its kind of nutrients, or if we eat food that is coated in that, actually, it can be a barrier for us absorbing nutrients because it's a foreign chemical getting into our body. So those are the two main reasons that I would choose to supplement. Also, I think our bodies are made to be in like perfect equilibrium, but if we're out of sync and if we're a bit out of balance, actually I think it's perfectly natural and where possible to just readdress that. You know, if you'd had a crazy weekend of partying and you know you're really tired, actually you would readdress the balance by sleeping in or having a few early nights that week. And I think it's a similar principle sometimes with supplements. And I think you've got to do it wisely, but I feel like it makes sense just restore that equilibrium and give little boosts to your body. I see supplements as boosts. The main thing is that you eat a naturally healthy diet where you don't eat processed foods, where you learn to listen to your body and refined sugars aren't in your diet, so you don't eat tons of gluten. Actually, those are the main things, and actually if you do those, you'll be completely healthy. But supplements just are a sort of little add-on boost. You don't need them, but they can really help with your health. The priority is not spending money on supplements. The priority will always be, for me, spending money on good quality food. But if you do want to take supplements, if you join me in my view, how do you do it? Well, I often really recommend taking maybe just one thing at a time for a month and seeing the impact that it would have on you. It's not good for you to be on certain supplements every day for the rest of your life. Actually, it's really good to chop and change different things in. So, for example, at the moment, as I'm beginning to rebalance and bring kind of balance to my hormones, I'm taking regular magnesium and regular chasteberry, which is a herb, but a kind of tincture. And those are the things I'm going to be focusing on for the next few months. And other months I might focus on probiotics. And other months when I was really focusing on healing my gut, that was like fermented cod liver oil and vitamin C and things like that. So it's not that you take everything all at once, you do it in stages and you take the recommended amount on the bottle and just see how you feel and adjust the levels according to that. So I hope this has been really helpful for you in terms of getting you thinking about supplements. I'd love to know if you are a supplement fan or if actually you think they're a bit weird and you don't want them in your diet. Just let me know in the comments below and let me know any other questions you have maybe about supplements. So I would love to answer your questions. Thank you so much for joining me as always, and I hope you have a splendid day. Okay, bye.